150,000 tons. That's how much road salt we in Toronto use every year. For context, that's nearly 50 Olympic-sized swimming pools of chloride salts. And yes, salts make our roads safer, but they can also compromise concrete, harm vegetation, and damage mobility devices like walkers and wheelchairs. And I'm sure we've all encountered the stubborn white stains on our shoes and clothing. Salts can also encourage rusting on vehicles and reduce the effectiveness of brakes, so really, they're a bit of a double-edged sword when it comes to road safety. Road salts have massive environmental impacts as well. We're seeing increasing concentrations of chloride from road salts in our waterways, and freshwater fish can't survive what's increasingly becoming a saltwater environment. For them, a winter is like 3 to 4 consecutive months of smog days. Can you imagine how your health would deteriorate living in those conditions? And let's not forget, we use those same waterways to drink, to play, and to fish. Now, it's not only road salt we need to worry about as an urban area either, but rainwater as well. This is because a city has so many paved surfaces that there isn't a lot of natural rainwater storage. So we get floods, and with them, infrastructure damage and transit delays that turn a 15-minute commute into an hour-long ordeal. A common method to address this is to build stormwater management ponds. These are man-made structures that allow rainwater collected from storm sewers to pool temporarily. Once that pool reaches a certain volume, an outlet releases the water to a nearby stream at a controlled rate, thus controlling the flow of water during heavy rain events, and hopefully keeping rainwater out of your basement. But what if the water pooling in these ponds is chock full of salt? What if the water we're releasing into the environment is carrying toxic concentrations of chloride? What if these structures that we created to address one problem are actually making another one much worse? Using field samples, high-frequency in-pond monitoring, and numerical modeling, our research aims to quantify how much chloride is being stored in these ponds so that we can assess their impact on downstream water quality. We are currently finding that water released from the ponds carries chronically toxic concentrations of chloride for over half of the year in residential areas and for nearly 90% of the year in commercial areas. Our research will provide valuable information to resource managers on how we need to act regarding salt use and flood control in order to improve downstream water quality, thereby making it safer for you and I to drink, to play, and to fish. Thank you.